I think SketchUp, a free 3D modeling program, can help you with your composition if you're learning to paint. Here's a picture I took recently on my iPhone. It's a little barn a friend of mine owns. I didn't like this little fence in there, so took Photoshop and got rid of it. But what to do with it? Well, let's go to SketchUp. It's loading. All right, what you can do in SketchUp, I'm just going to put a little square, 20 feet by 20 feet. So 20 feet, comma, 20 feet. I have the little foot symbols, bottom right corner. The blue means that's the back side, so I'm going to reverse the face, and that's the front side. Okay, so I have a little thing that's to scale. I can go to my camera, match new photo. I can go down and find my photo that I had and put it in. And what I'm going to do is put it in SketchUp in perspective. It's going to have a two-point perspective. So here's the origin right here, and I'm going to put that origin right on the corner of the building. And these are the perspective lines. So I'm going to move that perspective line. Sort of, you can see it on the barn there, right there. There's one line. It seems to be going off to the horizon line in the distance. Another one. I'll just put it on this line. Well, I'll put it on the bottom. And you can see perspective. These two lines are going to some horizon way out here somewhere. Do the same with the green lines. Put them down on the corners. And you get two-point perspective. And let's put this one on. It's a little bit in the way, that building, but it's sort of on a two-point. And it's pretty good. I mean, you can see the blue line is kind of on the corner of the building, and I can shift it around a little bit. Okay, what else? Well, look at the square. Now, I said it was 20 feet high. If I say this door is 10 feet, maybe another 10 feet would be here. So I'm going to just shrink this scale a little bit. So I'm going to say 20 feet is about here on the barn. That looks about right. So now I can go, I've got a match photo, I can go done. Now I could draw on this and I will have perspective drawing. It's a little hard to see, but if you draw, whatever I'm drawing is in perspective. Let's not draw though. What's the advantage of this whole thing? Well, let's put in a little plane here, another little ground, reverse it, go back to the photo match, project the textures onto this, and trim. And what that does is, if you look at it, it projected everything on here onto the plane I just put down. It just gives me a ground plane. All right, I'll go back to the picture. I can get rid of this square. I don't need it anymore. And what can I do? Well, let's go to the 3D warehouse and get some models. My picture is pretty basic. There's nothing in it. So let's say I go and get some cows. And I thought I had some 3D cows somewhere. Here's some 3D cows. I'm going to download it directly into SketchUp. Just takes a little while. Excuse me. I'm going to put it in the corner. And this person drew to scale. You can't see it. So there's a thing. If you go to Styles, you can go under Window, Styles, and you go to Edit, and you go to this last one. You can turn off this little button, and it makes everything visible. So we'll just do that. Now, if you look at it, let's just do a quick scale. Here's a pencil. From her foot to her head, if you look in the bottom right corner, it's about 5'5". I'd say that's about right. It's pretty tall cows. But let's click on it. Get rid of this little base. Explode it. Now I've got individual models. Now what good is that? Well, I can take a model and move it. this lady I'll move here. So when I go back to my picture, all of these cows are in perspective and the right size. So now I can look at my picture, and if I wanted to do a watercolor of it, I can say, look, I have all my cows in the right place. And you can go to shadows, turn on the shadows. And you can sort of see the shadows, if you line it up properly, of how it's going to look on different animals. And I can spin them around. Yeah. My computer's lagging a little bit, but spin them around to give a little variety. And I can just set up a scene. Right? I can sort of see the shadows on the ground. If I want to take this young lady and move her over here, she's exactly the right perspective and the right size. So if I was doing a sketch for a painting, everything would be to scale and my painting would look right from a two-point perspective. I mean, there's other things you can bring in. Let's turn off the sun. It just slows everything down. And go to something like a tractor. I don't know my tractors, but this looks like a good one. So if we put the tractor here on the ground, it might be a little big, so let's just measure it. I usually use a pencil tool just to go beside it and see how tall it is. And it looks like 7 feet. Now that seems a little big for a tractor, so I will just smoosh it down a little bit, maybe to there. Now I can go back. Right? But look at it. Now I have a tractor in perspective, in the right scale, and I can move it around anywhere I want for my composition. And I can turn my shadows on. And I can sort of see how the shadows will look in the picture. And then I could export this picture if I wanted to. Right? I could just go to export, 2D graphic. Let's go on untitled. I think it's already done it. So there's my picture, right? And I could use that to do a little sketch for a watercolor painting or any kind of painting. And everything is in the right perspective with the right shadows and the right scale. And I can move it around and get myself a pretty picture. I could erase other buildings, put new buildings in. So SketchUp is kind of a cool tool to give you some insight into two-point perspective, scale, and how to make your picture a little more interesting. Well, I hope this helps you out.